Ucypher, India's first multi-gaming, multi-platform esports championship. 6 teams of 14 players each compete across 4 games. Counter-Strike Global Offensive, Dota 2, Tekken 7, and Real Cricket 17. Each team faces the other team twice in the league stage. And 3 points each are awarded to the winning teams of Tekken 7 and Real Cricket 17 in each match. 5 points each are awarded to the winning teams of Dota 2 and CSGO games in a match. The top 4 teams in the league stage move to the knockout rounds. U Cypher, 6 teams, 84 cyber athletes, and a grand prize pool of 51 lakh rupees.
Hi guys, welcome to day 22 of India's first multi-platform, multi-gaming, multiplayer esports championship. My name is Aisha and this is U Cypher, Naya Sport, Naya Superstars. Today, the bottom two teams are going up against each other. It's the Crusaders versus the Yodhas. The Crusaders are at number 6 and the Yodhas are at number 5.
The last battle between the two teams ended up in a tie. Both the teams had 8 points each. This is a must win for both the Crusaders and the Yodhas to stay in the competition. The decider is today. So let's find out what's going to happen. Without wasting any more time, let's dive straight into the games.
कौन है आप? पंगा लेगा क्या?
नहीं।
या तो?
मारेंगे।
कैसे?
ऐसे।
Wow. Guys, starting off on the offensive, huh? You guys actually don't have a choice. You have to win today. पिछली बार Crusaders के साथ you guys also drew. लेकिन practice थोड़ी अलग की है.
Yes, we won last time, but today we are out of form. And we have lost 4 games continuously in the league. And we have practiced a lot, we haven't slept. And today we are very composed. Boys are focused. And today we will win. And Dota is in form.
I'm super excited to watch the Yodhas up against the Crusaders. And these guys are not taking this day lightly.
Crusaders.
Yeah.
Today you have a do or die situation. Today is like your finals.
Yeah.
If you don't do team sweep today, you're out.
We have like a very grim chances on us clean sweeping Yodhas today and then waiting for others to lose. But this is a very bad way to qualify actually. Like you don't want to qualify in a league in this way. But aaj pure pumped up hai, 16-0 karna hai aaj. Aur Osama ne bhai aaj vaada de diya usne. Because now we can't expect him to lose and then, you know, go ahead. So aaj usko day start karna hai 3 point ke saath and then I think so we'll follow up good and we'll go for a 16-0 today.
Team Crusaders, keep the confidence up. All the best, Captain. All the best, team. Come on.
Welcome to Match Day 22 Ucypher ke Championship. And today's face-off is Crusaders and Yodhas. Ke beech mein. But before that, let's just look at the leaderboard.
In the first position, at the moment, we have the Yakshas on 71 points. On second, we have the Marksman at 67. And the Shaders at third position with 62 points.
And Akramaks are at 56 points. They are at the fourth position. And then we have Yodhas, 47 points, fifth position. Last, Crusaders at the bottom of the table with just 33 points.
Yeah, exactly. Today's matchup, both teams at the bottom of the table, Crusaders versus Yodhas, they have everything to play for today.
Yodhas have
drawn.
Yeah, they're the masters when it comes to drawing the games. They have 4 games which they have tied basically in the Ucypher Championship.
Right.
And Crusaders are yet to kind of see a victory. Mm. So it'll be quite an interesting game, man.
Let's see what they can do. Tekken 7 coming up next.
Like Varun said, today is do or die for both our teams, the Yodhas and the Crusaders. 21 din of Ucypher have gone by. And if there's one thing that we have learned, it is that drawing first blood, winning the first game, really gives you an advantage of confidence. Let's not take this lightly. This game is Tekken 7.
Players apne character select karenge. हर राउंड में जिसका एचपी खत्म हो जाएगा वो राउंड हार जाएगा हर मैच एक रेस है 3 राउंड्स जीतने की और जो प्लेयर पहले 3 मैचेस जीतेगा वो बनेगा टेकन 7 का विनर लेट द बैटल बिगिन
इन द लास्ट टेकन 7 मैच क्रिस्पी डिस्ट्रॉयड ओजी 3-1 3-1 3-0 बट दिस टाइम ओजी हैज प्रॉमिस्ड अ मैसेकर Crispy, that sounds like a death threat, man. Any last words?
Maybe he's taken me for granted.
Taken you for granted. Aussie, is that the case?
So, he's going to lose. So, after a game, I'll give him a job.
Wow. I've been advised not to let these two face each other in real life, but let them fight in Tekken 7.
Welcome back to another game of the U Cypher League. Now it's between the Yodhas versus the Crusaders. On Yodhas, we have Archie's Crispy. And on Crusaders, we have Ozzy.
Round one. Fight.
Well, the game starts, and good blocks from Puma, but not for long. He is taking the damage, and that laser, a huge damage. And again, the second time, the third time as well, that's a spam, and ends the first round with a perfect
fight.
But the second round starts with a bear hug on Devil Jin. A good block from him, but now he's going for the hits and going for the laser with the next one. And he is giving such a huge damage to Puma. Puma just going low on HP. Just a hit away from Rage Art. Now Puma has Rage Art, but that was blocked from Devil Jin, and that's gonna be a knockout.
Round three.
This is round number three, and Devil Jin applying a lot of pressure over Puma. Puma going low on HP, and that whip punish with that laser on Puma. Well, now Devil Jin with good blocks. Well, the Rage Art is on Puma, but block from Devil Jin. And now he is just stepping backwards, trying to maintain the distance and not trying to take any damage from Puma. And now this is gonna be a knockout. Well, the Yodhas win match number one, 3-0.
Round one. Fight.
This is match number two, and Devil Jin not showing any mercy, just pushing on towards Akuma, but Akuma with good blocks as well. And this is actually a character change for him, like on towards the Crusader side. From Devil Jin, and that swing in the air and slaps to the ground, just like a little bit of HP left on Akuma, but that Rage Art from him does connect on Devil Jin. Devil Jin just going low on HP, and what an amazing comeback.
Unblockable.
Nice thinking.
Round two. Fight.
A good clash at the start of the round, good trade-off between these two, and Devil Jin with that his Devil's Eye that just maintained that distance, not even allowing Akuma to come close to him. And Akuma as well with his Hadouken over there, but still a huge distance between them, and now an HP lead on Devil Jin. Well, the Rage Art does connect from Akuma, but it's still gonna leave Devil Jin on her huge HP lead. Akuma tried to push in, but it's gonna be a knockout.
Round three. Fight.
A good counter coming in from Devil Jin, and again with his Devil's Eyes, that damage on Akuma is really high. Well, now he has read the game and still trying to play a little bit smart, and he is going low on HP, stuck into the corners. Devil Jin not giving him any chance, and it's gonna be a knockout.
Round four. Fight.
But a nice start to the game. Akuma at least trying to apply a little bit of pressure on Devil Jin. And now Devil Jin as well, like good blocks from Akuma. And a good reversal from these players. And now Akuma with he uses his super, but still not able to give like a huge damage on Devil Jin. Good blocks from Akuma. Now the players are equal on HP, but that laser is gonna give him a huge damage. Akuma does have the Rage Art, and well, it does connect. And it's gonna leave Devil Jin less on a little bit of HP. But now Devil Jin has the Rage Art on him. But will he be able to execute on time? No, this uses the laser and the Hadouken from Akuma. And it's a huge mistake from Devil Jin. So nice comeback from Akuma.
Fight.
Devil Jin playing aggressive over Akuma. He is applying a lot of pressure on him, but good blocks from Akuma as well. Now that damage is huge over Akuma, not giving him a single chance to return in the game. A good block from Devil Jin. Well, Akuma is now stuck into the corners. He has the Rage Art.
but not giving him any time to execute it, and it's gonna be a knockout. So the Yodhas win match number 2-3-2.
Round one. Fight.
Well, he misses the lower kick, and that was a whip punish, but nice punches from him as well over Devil Chain, and a good reversal from both of the players. But now he is applying pressure over Akuma. Akuma has gone low on HP, and now Devil Chain into the corners, but a good hit from him. Now Akuma is gonna get a knockout.
Fight.
Good sidestep at the round start, and now Devil Jin just rushing over him. A good trade-off from both of the players, and now Devil Jin just trying to make that move, but that was actually a nice move coming in from Akuma. And well, these both players are trying to maintain a distance. Akuma trying to go aggressive, but the Devil Jin with that laser. Well, the Hadouken, he tried to jump over it, but he couldn't, and he did take a damage. Now Akuma is going low on HP. Devil Jin applying a lot of pressure on him. Devil Jin trying to maintain that distance. He is stuck in the corner, but a good reversal coming in from him. Well, the rage out does not connect, and now it's gonna be a punish from him, and it's a knockout.
Round three. Fight.
This could be the last round for Devil Jin if he wins this. Look at the cheeky play he is playing over Akuma. And that amazing slam to the ground. Devil Jin just slams and connects with the laser as well. Akuma already low on HP with that head tackle on Devil Jin. And that rage art does connect to Devil Jin. Well, he is still on a huge HP lead. And now Akuma just an HP left, and he is just going low, and that is gonna be a knockout. And the Yodhas have won the game.
Man, today you chose Devil Jin, yeah. Which was so exciting to watch you play, because last time Ucypher mein jab kisi ne khela tha, they couldn't exactly connect all of the combos, but today you did a fantastic job.
Yeah, but Devil Jin is a very hard character to master, and I had very less time. Uh-huh. I just had ODA. Oh. And my team was completely under pressure because I have been losing a lot in a streak, and I had to break that jinx. And the first game is over, and we're really looking forward for the next three games to win. Ukhaad ke.
All right. Was 3 points to the Yodhas.
Up next, we have Real Cricket 17. This championship ko 22 days ho gaye hai, and this matchup ki ek bahut khas baat hai. Killer V of Crusaders has only won one match in this entire championship against Kunwa of the Yodhas. So will the Yodhas get their revenge, or will the Crusaders get their second victory in Real Cricket 17? Let's find out.
ये एक batting only match है. हर प्लेयर एक ओवर फेस करेगा जिसमें उसे मैक्सिमम रन्स बनाने होंगे. मैक्सिमम रन्स बनाने वाला प्लेयर मैच जीत जाएगा. टाई होने पर दोनों प्लेयर्स एक सुपर ओवर खेलेंगे टू डिसाइड द विनर.
जैसा कि मैंने कहा कि आज का डे दोनों टीम्स के लिए डू और डाई है, तो कौन कॉल कर
रहा
है? I call. I call. Yeah. Head.
Bat first.
Bat first.
Yeah.
And if you win?
Same, bat first.
Tails.
Tail, bat first.
So they already have an added advantage. So isse Kunwa ko kuch farak padega?
Nahi, main abhi jaake baat karunga usse. So bolta hu, it's okay. Six balls, tujhe bhi milenge, usse bhi milenge. Batting first, second se kuch nahi hota.
All right. All the best, captain. All the best. May the best team win.
Welcome back to another game of Real Cricket, and now it's gonna be the Yodhas versus the Crusaders. It's gonna be Killer B from the Crusaders to bat first. First ball coming in for the Crusaders, and that's a huge hit. It's going for a six. And the second ball comes in, and he missed it. Third ball for the Crusaders, and he missed another one. Three balls, six runs. Fourth ball for the Crusaders, and that's a whack towards the boundary. It's going for a six. Second last ball of the over. And he missed it again. So five balls, 12 runs. Last ball of the over. And that's towards the boundary. It's a six. Yodhas now need 19 runs to win this game. Now it's Sachin's turn to bat next. First ball for the Yodhas, and that's a huge hit, but it's still gonna go for a four. Second ball coming in, and that's a good shot. It's rolling towards the boundary, it's a four. Third ball comes in. A good shot towards the boundary. It's going for a six. The Yodhas now need 5 runs in 3 balls. The fourth ball comes in. And that's a whack towards the boundary. It's going for a six. And the Yodhas have won the game.
Scoreboard currently is a ticking bomb. In whose favor is it going to explode? Let's find out in this game of CSGO.
इस गेम में दो टीम्स होती हैं, एक टेररिस्ट टीम और दूसरी काउंटर टेररिस्ट टीम। ये एक टीम बेस्ड गेम है जो 5 वर्सेस 5 के फॉर्मेट में खेला जाएगा। प्लेयर्स कौन सा मैप खेलेंगे, ये एक बैनिंग प्रोसेस से तय होगा। शुरुआत में दोनों टीम्स को $800 की गेम करेंसी मिलती है। The aim of the terrorist team is to plant the bomb and secure it or kill all the counter terrorists. The aim of the counter terrorist team is to either defuse the bomb or kill all the terrorists. इस मैच में 30 राउंड्स होंगे and the first team to win 16 rounds is the game winner. In the case of a tie, the result will be decided with a race to 4 wins.
Strategy ka time khatam ho chuka hai and we are about to move straight into the action. Crusaders have not won a single game this morning so far, but you guys are at 6 points. It's a cool streak, the confidence is high and I could see a lot of stuff happening in the strategy rooms. Kya chal raha tha?
Ki hum jo last consecutive haar rahe 4 games saath mein, to kya mistakes ho rahi thi aur kya kya galat ho raha tha, wo sab hum fix karke aaye aaj.
Yodhas full prepared dikh rahe hain. Rem star for your boys today, it's extremely important that they give in their best.
Yeah, I've told them like we won't be able to qualify into top 4, but then I've told them just to play their individual games and you know do good at it.
Wow, more power to you, man.
Thank you.
Good luck, Waz.
Thank you.
Not that you need it.
good luck.
Hello everyone, it's time for Counter-Strike between the Yodhas and the Crusaders. This is the map veto and now let's see what do they choose. And it's gonna be cobblestone! Well, as you know, it's gonna be a knife round between these two teams and the winner of the knife round will get to choose the side. So that is T as in terrorist and CT as in counter-terrorist. Well, the knife begins and gears power to get to the first frag and friction for the second one. Grizzler going for the next one and Texter with a good backstab over here. And now it's all on coverage, a 1-on-3 situation, getting those easy frags and winning the knife round. So the Crusaders have won the knife round and they choose to play as T's first. And looks like the Yodhas have a strategy of a foam ban on bomb site B. And the Crusaders are now rushing towards mid. So looks like it's gonna be an A rush coming in from the Crusaders. The players are now heavily rushing towards mid, and here's Marklon getting the first attack and Buzz with the second one. A good, nice tag team between these two players. Magic rushing on the side, but now he's down by Marklon. Going for the third one, but no, it's going to be Kavish to shut him down. And now Chris is over here. Friction is low on HP, and now Chris is just struggling, but now he gets a frag on Friction. Chris coming in from the drop zone gets an easy frag on Pexa. Well, Pexa goes down. Now it's going to be a one-on-two situation for Wuz. Wuz is just being a sandwich right over here. He is just fighting with those players, and now it's going to be the Crusaders to win the first round. The Crusaders have pushed towards the bomb side B. A Molly goes in, and that is going to make the players push. And now Marklon getting a kill through the smoke. And one more trade frag as well from the players. Now it's a 3-on-4 situation. Marklon holding the posi quite well behind the stone. Magic moving towards the bomb side quietly. And now it's going to plant the C4. Marklon rushing towards the C4 guy, and it's going to be a nice frag for him. It's a 1-on-3 situation for Power, and Power goes down by Wuz. Well, that previous round gave a huge economical damage to the Yodhas. It's gonna be Pexa pushing in, but that is gonna be punished from the Crusaders, and that is not looking good for them because it's an eco round for them, and now suddenly it's a 3-on-5 situation for them. Well, a good frag from Friction. Well, he gets one frag, and Magic shutting down Marklon over to the bombsite A, and now it's a 1-on-4 situation for Friction. He has snatched the AK, but he might actually go for a save. A very well executed round coming in from the Crusaders. Holding towards the connectors, he hears a player, and with the CZ he shuts down Power, and now Chris is struggling with his bullet, but still managed to get a frag on Marklon. Rizla holding with the AWP towards the mid, but he is actually low on HP.
Rizla ne ek shot liya pehle A long pe, usko mara aur fir wo chup gaya wapas se. To kya dekhte hain, 2-3 second baad Rizla ek aur nikal ke marta hai mid pe. Fir se chup jaate hain.
What an amazing skill by Rizla, getting those three easy frags for the team. Well, Wuz with his pistol, he's holding towards the team in stairs, and now he's struggling with his bullets. Well, Kavish over here gets a frag on Friction, and a second frag as well on Wuz, and he is now going on a killing spree. Well, three kills coming in for him. A 2-on-5 situation for the Yodhas, and they are on eco, but Kavish taking the huge damage from that CZ. He is just on 14 HP, but he is now pushing and gets a frag on Rizla. Now Marklon getting that AK and gets an easy headshot over Krish, but Kavish ends the misery for Marklon.
Nice.
Ending the score for 10-5.
Now the first half of the Counter-Strike game between the Crusaders and Yodhas just got over. The Crusaders got a big lead of 10-5. After going down the single player games, this is a great boost for their confidence.
Magic Mouse is performing really well out here for the team. Also Kavish, especially in the last round, you know, killing five players, getting an ace, they have got it going for them.
Let's see if the Crusaders can close it out, get the 5 points, and give their Dota 2 team a chance to win today's face-off.
So 10-5 is the score for the first half. Now it's time for second half. The Crusaders will now play as CTs, and the Yodhas will now play as Ts. Wuz was with a heavy rush towards the A mains, and now he gets a kill over there on Krish, and the players are rushing towards the bomb site. Marklon on A bomb site. He is actually going to plant the C4. Now it's a 4-1-4 situation for the players. Well, Wurz is struggling with his accuracy towards the connectors. And there comes a backstab from Power. He gets down Pexer, and Wurz gets a frag on Magix. Well, friction over here towards the CT connectors.
Wurz just ट्रक से मेरे तरफ देख रहा था, बट वो रिलोड कर रहा था, तो उस पर मैंने वन बुलेट ESP मारा हेड. मैं उसका फ़ायदा उठाया, मैं ट्रक पे चढ़ा, सीधा साइड के ऊपर कूदा और जैसे उतर रहा था मैंने उसे मार दिया.
Well, that was a huge risk from Power, but he still manages to get the round. Friction holding towards long A and an easy tap. Krish goes down. What an amazing shot. Well, that flash is going to give a team flash to Rizla. He has got blinded, but still now he's managing to get a frag over Power. So now it's a 3-on-5 situation. Well, the Crusaders are low on their men, and now it's going to be a 1-on-4 situation for Magix. He is just with his farmers. But Friction with a good angle, he shuts him down with a headshot. Flash is coming in on bomb set B. Magix over here with his CZ. He gets a frag on Wurz, and Rex gets a frag on Marklon. And then now the players are moving from long A. A good molly coming in from Pexer towards the balcony. He shuts down Krish, and now he's going to plant the C4. Well, it's a nice situation for the Crusaders because they have two rifles on them, two AKs. But now it's going to be Power to go down next.
Rex ne CZ se ek bande ko pick kara, uski AK leke aur ek bande ko pick kara. और राउंड ऐसे ही ट्रेड्स होते होते राउंड 1-on-1 तक आ गया था, लेकिन वो लोग का प्लेयर फ्रिक्शन बहुत अच्छा खेला. पर वो राउंड इकोनॉमी डैमेज हमने बहुत करी, तो वो राउंड देखा जाए तो हमारे ही फेवर में था.
वेल, अ गुड नेट टुवर्ड्स द लॉन्ग ए, बट क्रिश नॉट गोना टेक दैट ह्यूज डैमेज, बट Pexer knew that there was a player holding there, and Krish goes down. Was holding here for the push from the Crusaders. He's still watching, and now it's gonna be Kavish who's gonna enter and go down instantly. And Rizla is onto the side. The C4 has been planted by the Yodhas, and it's a 3-on-5 situation. Not looking good for the Crusaders, but they do have like a round lead, but they are on eco. Well, Rizla getting a frag on Power, and now the second frag is gonna be Rex. Well, the Crusaders are on match point, and Yodhas can still tie it up. And Rex is shutting down two players instantly. Kavish with a nice frag, and Krish with this op shot as well. Now it's all on Rizla to win this for his team. It's a 1-on-3 situation for him. The C4 is dropped just close to him. On the side, there is a smoke. The players now have info that Rizla is on towards the B platform. And now it's a shot from Krish, which is gonna end the game for the Yodhas. 16-14, the scoreline, and the Crusaders win the game.
कुछ राउंड्स हम ऐसे हार रहे थे जो हमें नहीं हारने चाहिए थे, तो बेसिकली इको राउंड जो हम चार हारे थे, पर क्योंकि हम लोग ने इको राउंड्स थ्रो करे बेसिकली, तो इसके वजह से मैच बहुत क्लोज गया, वरना बहुत पहले ही मैच जीता थे.
Our CSGO winners are the Crusaders. Guys, you have got 5 points now, and were you expecting this?
Honestly telling you, today after knowing the first two like game result, we were almost out of the tournament. So he got emotional, he cried a bit. He just told me that next 3 games, I'm not going to let anyone win.
Wow, Krish was so right. He was really determined. Crazy performances, and there has to be a winner. This time it was the Crusaders, lekin abhi ek game baki hai.
Abhi Dota baki
hai. Abhi Dota baki hai. Dekhte hai. Oh, wow.
Farak nahi padta.
All right, guys, I'll let you get back to your teams. Congratulations.
Good luck, bro.
Well, this day has been an intense emotional roller coaster for all of us here, and we're still left with one game to end day 22.
Welcome back to U Cypher, Naya Sport, Naya Superstars. The scores after game 3 are Crusaders at 5 and Yodhas at 6. Now comes the decider. The game is Dota 2.
डोटा 2 में हर प्लेयर अपने लिए एक हीरो सिलेक्ट करेंगे। इस गेम में दो टीम्स कम्पीट करेंगी इन अ 5v5 फॉर्मेट। हर हीरो के पास स्पेशल पावर्स और एबिलिटीज होती हैं। हर टीम का ऑब्जेक्टिव है अपने एंशंट्स को डिफेंड करना और अपने ओपोनेंट के सारे टावर्स को डिस्ट्रॉय कर देना। जो टीम पहले एनिमी टीम के डिफेंस को तोड़कर उनके सारे टावर्स डिस्ट्रॉय कर देगी वो टीम जीतेगी।
हेलो गाइस, योद्धास के साथ आज मैच है। लास्ट टाइम हम लोग खेले, हम लोग बहुत वन साइडेड जीते। ओवर कॉन्फिडेंट नहीं होना है क्योंकि लास्ट टाइम हराए थे, because we know they are very strong team now.
इतना मत सोचो वो लोग क्या करने वाले हैं। Let's stick to our plan. हम बहुत ही अच्छे फॉर्म में हैं। अपन जैसे खेल रहे हैं टीम फाइट बेस्ड, वैसे ही खेलते हैं।
तो पुश खेलेंगे, मतलब पांचों ग्रुप अप होंगे और लोग पुश करने वाले। डोम तो बैन नहीं कर दे ऑफ लेन में, और टाइड एंटर बैन कर देना।
उन लोगों ने रोल स्विच किया है। इनविंसिबल खेल रहा है कैरी रोल और अतुल खेल रहा है उन लोग का मिड सोलो। आज का गेम बहुत ही ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट है अपने लिए।
ये गेम हमारा तो सीएस वाले घुमा घुमा के मारेंगे।
चलो
चलो
प्ले अ गेम। ऑलराइट,
1 2 3 गो यूदास,
कम ऑन।
The last game was really close, but then Crusaders, you had won the last game, and now it's time for Dota 2, the decider, to actually stay in the competition. So how nervous are you going in the game today?
Today I'm nervous because every time our CS guys win, we lose. And last time when we played them, we beat them. I was confident last time because मुझे पता था इनकी टीम के प्लेयर सब नए हैं, इतने confident नहीं हैं, तो और गेम में भी दिखा था, tough हुआ था, but we won.
इनका जो paper पे है team, that's one of the best teams. Yep. So are you scared because of last time हारे थे इनसे?
I'm not scared really, but I know they're going to give us a great game. We won our previous 4 games. But we have to play our best to beat these guys.
Yeah, this will be a fun game to watch. Yeah. All the best.
They are playing to stay in the tournament. We are playing for pride, honor, and you know, at least win one face-off.
Yeah. So let's see what happens.
Have been on quite a streak here at U Cypher Season 1. The question is, can the Crusaders put an end to this? Invincible straight off and end up falling in that safe lane just 3 minutes in.
Yeah, looks like Crusaders not having a fantastic start here. Now 13 minutes in, the score sitting at 13-9, still in favor of Acme and the boys on the side of Yoda. Bakimoto on the top lane. It is nighttime. He's trying to go in for a kill here, but Kale turns around with a Venomous Kale and the Poison Nova. Senjin trying to fight his way through this. Kale gets stunned up. Bakimoto's been kiting around him nicely so far, but with the tree in coming in from behind, they get the root off. They use an overgrowth for good measure and turn it around.
Yeah, that's the power of the Venomancer. I mean, one would believe that after the changes in the recent patch, the Venomancer would be done for. But Darshan comes in with the Blink Dagger, gets one, that's the Acme tree, then follows up with the kill onto the Venomancer. 18 minutes in, it's been a really close game. So far, the Yodhas on the dial with a small net worth lead of 4,000 gold. Abs, though, he's being hunted here in the top lane. The dust has already been committed. Abs looks to turn fight with the cold snap, but the mana void as well as the damage from Invincible just too much.
20 minutes in, 19-14 the score. Shondi and the boys going up to the high ground now. Kale He's pretty huge at this point. I mean, he's picked up the veil quite early on. This push is just relentless coming out from the Yodhas. Bakemono is trying to defend with everything he's got here. It does feel like the Yodhas have the late game security as well. Even though they're up against something like an anti-mage, they have what it takes to go late. But Darshan says he wants to start the fight. That might have been a bit premature, and with the cold snap, he doesn't even get the primers clear off. There's the buyback from Darshan, but the chain frost is already wreaking all sorts of havoc here. Bakemono survives, and an eclipse was sort of wasted here. Coming out from the Yodhas.
Yodhas once again grouping up, looking for the objective. Exorcism committed by Remsar. Darshan goes in with the clapping finger of death. Committed, still not securing a kill. Hexed up, Acme might be in trouble. The meteor's there from Aps, doesn't connect on anyone. They've lost Acme on the tree, and while Bakemono tries to man-fight Shondi, ends up losing. Now Invincible inside the middle of the Yodhas lineup, searching for some sort of redemption. Will probably find Kale here, as the Earth Spike from the line did hold him in place long enough. Invincible working hard, finally securing a double kill for himself. And just like that, the Crusaders managed to hold on to the high ground.
Yeah, the storyline at U Cypher has been 4 protect 1, and most of the teams haven't found themselves that opportunity to go higher ground, or rather they haven't exploited the opportunities to go higher ground quickly enough. Now, let's see if this is an opportunity for them to turn it around. Acme, Kale going with the smoke now, trying to gain back their lost momentum here.
Radiant,
the network lead has actually swung back in favor of the Crusaders, but this one fight could change it all. Shondi and Co on the high ground, now coming back to the low ground. There's the Eclipse, the Overgrowth as well, just taking out Darshan before the fight even begins. That's a quick, clean kill on the Brewmaster, and perhaps they'll get an objective like Roshan on the back of this.
Last game of the day,
yeah.
And Yodhas have a fantastic draft right now.
Right.
And it's working for them, they're attacking aggressively. I mean, they might just win again.
Looking at the form coming into this game, they won the last 4 Dota 2 games. Yeah.
How does Crusaders plan to defend this?
Well, I think Crusaders firstly need to get their game set right. Whenever they have the momentum going, I don't know, the last game they kind of then lose it out there. Yeah. I think it's really tough for them now. They'll be out of the tournament soon.
Well, on that note, the game is still left. We never know what happens.
Shardini quite liberal with the use of his Eclipse, and the boys from the side of the Yodhas, they are marching high ground. Shondi on the front lines, commits the Eclipse, doesn't get too much done with it. The finger of death coming up from the line, pushing Shondi back for the time being, but the primal split from Darshan. The question is, can it control anyone on the side of the Yodhas? Acme is hiding in the trees, but he's not really safe. They've got detection. A treant running around the trees will not survive for long. Ends up going down. Invincible is dominating. The rest of the Yodhas controlled by Darshan and his panda. Aff turns around, drops the EMP, looks run the clap, slug him down. Shondi with the Masked Man is looking to fight. He's got the Aegis, he's got that security, he's comfortable giving it up. And there's the Meteor and the Deafening Blast. Find Shondi a double kill, and along with the Chain Frost, they'll bring down Invincible.
They just pressed all of their buttons as soon as they came up onto the high ground. Good stuff from the Yodhas, commandeering the high ground and turning around. Now 33 minutes in, the Yodhas looking to secure another lane of barracks, this time towards the middle lane, as Shondi leads the charge with a freshly picked up Butterfly and Alacrity thrown upon him as well. He's just laying into the buildings, but Darshan initiates. The Eclipse instantly popped there, and again Darshan goes down without the Primus Blade, rise back to the fight. Death Prophet being controlled for now, but Remstar's out in no man's land and ends up going down. No buyback for Remstar. A tier 3 in jeopardy. There's Invincible trying to enter the fight as well. He does get the Mana Void off. Bakemono buys back to so much economic damage being dished out here against the Crusaders. But the buildings have still taken a beating. Apps even gets the kill on Bakemono with the Sun Strikes there. Now, Acme, in a little bit of trouble, commits the Overgrowth, tries to make a run for it now, makes his way back towards the north side, but the Broolings are still chasing him. Shondi controlled for a while with the Tornado, but now Darshan is reassembled. He's gone back for the barracks, while Kale is just zoning them out. Bakemono sent back to the fountain from whence he came.
While Shondi and the rest of the while Shondi and the Yodhas do manage to secure another lane of barracks, they're moving towards the top lane. Darshan on his last limb here, trying to somehow defend, but the Luna with the glaives just pushing back the Crusaders. The Yodhas have secured all 3 lanes of barracks. I'm not really sure how the Crusaders find their way back into this. In fact, it seems as if they've accepted their fate. They're AFK in the base, the anti-mage disconnected in the fountain. The Yodhas have secured victory for themselves.
Yodhas playing some good Dota here, still showing that they are proving to be the team to beat at Ucypher Season 1.
Your dad.
Well, they needed a win to stay in the hunt for the top four, and they've done just that, the Yodhas. And with the captain, Pranay, aka Waz.
Yes.
Pranay, must be a really good feeling because you really, really needed that one. It was very important.
Yes, it was a great feeling. Finally, we needed to win 4-0 on this day to come in fourth position. But we won three games and we lost the CS. Yeah. But yeah, I'm happy for the day.
Aur kitna confident hai abhi ki you will make the top four because it's a crucial juncture in the league right now.
We काफी confident हूँ because Dota ने तो अच्छा perform कर ही रहे हैं काफी अच्छे से वो लोग खेल रहे हैं वो लोग हर मैच जीत रहे हैं depends on us and on Tekken player and cricket to win and we will come in final semi final.
Well, we want to see you there as well. The Yodhas are back to winning ways. They found their winning feet here versus the Crusaders. 3-1 overall the score here and a win for this man and the team in red.
It's been a game-changing day of gaming for both our teams today. The Yodhas finally managed to break their cycle of either losing or drawing by winning their first match ever on U Cypher, securing them a spot in the championship. The Crusaders are at the bottom of the table, but they fought with courage and like warriors. This is what the leaderboard looks like now.
Congratulations, Team Yodhas, for that wonderful victory and for improving your rank on the leaderboard. If you guys want to watch every detail on how Team Yodhas got their first match victory, you can log on to usports.in, watch and learn how winning is done. Tomorrow we have Akramaks versus the Yakshas. Both the teams will be playing for respect and for improving the rank on the leaderboard. We'll be seeing you guys tomorrow, same time, same place, only on Ucypher Naya Sport, Naya Superstars, a U-Sports initiative. My name is Varun.
And I'm Aisha.
Do Ucypher.
आज है मेरे पास जॉन्डी टैंक के लिए एंटी टैंक नया टैंक्स अबाउट टू ब्लो
चेले ने आपको टॉस में भी हरा दिया
अपन ने वो लोग तो वन साइड ठोक दिया था
आज अपने सीएस में थोड़ा ट्रिकी खेलते हैं
रिपेयर तो सबको हराने के लिए किया है तो ये हो या कोई और हो कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता
नमक स्वादानुसार और अकड़ औकात अनुसार ये याद रखना